हेलो चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट एनालिटिकल केमिस्ट्री, न्यू चैप्टर, फोर्थ चैप्टर. ओके, सो लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड फर्स्ट व्हाट इज एनालिसिस, बिकॉज दिस चैप्टर एनालिटिकल केमिस्ट्री इज बेस्ड ऑन एनालिसिस ऑफ सब्सटेंस. एनालिसिस ऑफ सब्सटेंस, सो लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज एनालिसिस फर्स्ट. ओके, इफ यू टॉक अबाउट एनालिसिस, एनालिसिस मीन्स determination of chemical substance. Analysis means determination of chemical component present in a substance. Clear? So what is analysis? Analysis is the way to know what components are present in a substance. What components are present in a substance is known as analysis. Clear? Here I have written definition. Determination of chemical component present in a substance is known as analysis. Analysis is of two types. Qualitative analysis and second is quantitative analysis. Clear? There are two types of analysis, qualitative analysis and quantitative analysis. So let us understand what is qualitative and quantitative analysis. Clear? So first one is qualitative analysis. Qualitative analysis means to know the substance present in a unknown substance, or you can say identification of an unknown substance. Okay? Qualitative analysis involves identification of an unknown substance. Okay? So whatever method you use to identify an unknown substance by carrying out chemical test with the help of reagent is known as qualitative analysis. Clear? So the identification of an unknown substance by carrying out chemical test with the help of reagent is known as qualitative analysis. Clear? I hope you people understood what is analysis, what is qualitative analysis. Right? Now come at what is quantitative analysis. Okay? Quantitative analysis. As the name is representing quantity. So here we identify, we try to know, okay, about the quantity of a substance or chemical component present in a substance. Okay, how much quantity of chemical components are present in a substance, that we try to know with the help of quantitative analysis. Right? Clear? See, though this quantitative analysis we will understand, we will learn in higher classes, here in this chapter we are going to learn only about qualitative analysis. One more term came when we are discussing about qualitative analysis, that is reagent. Clear? So let us understand what is reagent. Clear? Very simple. A reagent is a substance that reacts with another substance. A reagent is a substance that reacts with another substance. In the lab. Okay? A reagent is a substance which reacts with other substance. More often used reagent in the lab is sodium hydroxide, ammonium hydroxide. They are very frequently used reagent in the lab. So we will understand the use of these reagents, especially in this chapter, analytical chemistry. Ammonium hydroxide and sodium hydroxide as reagent. What are the function of these two reagents? How they are used in the identification of a component or a substance? Clear? Especially we will understand how sodium hydroxide and ammonium hydroxide can be used to identify an unknown substance in the lab. Clear? If we talk about how to identify the substance in a lab with the help of these reagents. So whenever these reagents react with unknown substance, they give color. With the help of that color, we understand what are the cations present in the unknown substance. What are the anions present in the unknown substance? Clear? So whenever reagent sodium hydroxide and ammonium hydroxide react with unknown substance, they form precipitated hydroxide. So these reagents especially react with soluble salt. Okay, so when they react with soluble salt of metal, they form hydroxide of respective metals. Okay, and that hydroxides are colored hydroxide, and that color represent what type of cations and anions are present in the substance, unknown substance. Right? Now come at color of salts and their solution. Color of the salts. See, if you talk about color of the salts, so a salt is colored due to cations and anions, due to present cation and anion in the salt. We all know a salt is consist of cations and anions, right now? Because salts are ionic compound, and ionic compounds are consist of ions, that is cation and anion. Okay, yeah. With a very simple example, we can see NaCl consists of cation Na plus and anion Cl minus. Clear? So color of this sodium chloride is due to sodium plus and Cl minus. We all know that they both don't have any color, that's why sodium chloride is colorless. Clear? If you talk about color of cations, in periodic table, representative elements do not show any color. Okay, if you talk about ions of representative elements, they do not have any color. Okay, what are representative elements? Group number 1, 2, and from 13 to 17 are known as representative elements. These elements in the ionic form do not show any color. Means they are colorless. So which elements show color in ionic form? Especially from group number 3 to 12. That is transition element. That is transition element. Clear? So if we talk about colored compound or colored cations, they belong to transition element. Means from group number 3 to 12. So most of the cations, colored cations or colored salt, you see, they belong to transition element from group number 3 to group number 12. Means salts consist of cations which belongs to transition element, D block element. Transition element is also known as D block element. Right? In previous classes, I have told you all some trick. With the help of that trick, you can easily understand the color of different cations. Again, I will repeat here. I have told you all some trick. Green crow vi nahi fasa blue cup me. Blue cup me. Green crow vi nahi fasa blue cup me. This is the way to learn the color cation. Green is the color. How many cations show green color? Chromium. Cr. 3 plus. Chrome means chromium. V means vanadium 3 plus. Nahi means nickel. Nickel 2 plus. Nickel 2 plus. Fasa means ferrous. Fe 2 plus. Okay. So Cr means chromium cation, vanadium 3 plus, nickel 3 plus, 2 plus, sorry, and iron 2 plus. They all show green color. Right? Blue cup may, blue is the color, cup for copper 2 plus. Copper 2 plus. So copper 2 plus show which color? Blue color. Right? One more trick I will tell you all. Man ko gulabi rakho. Gulabi rakho. This man is Mn 2 plus. Manganese 2 plus. This is cobalt 2 plus. And color is pink. Gulabi means pink color. So Mn 2 plus and cobalt 2 plus. So pink color. Clear? Pink color. Right? Now, some anions also have color MnO4. I'm talking about magnet, permanganate, MnO4 minus CrO4, CrO4 2 minus and Cr2O7 2 minus. They also represents color. Okay? So, permanganate, chromate and dichromate. Permanganate, chromate and dichromate. In the sequence you can write here PYO, PYO, PYO. P stands for pink color, means magnet, permanganate represents pink color. Chromate represents yellow color and dichromate represents orange color. Orange color. Okay, so color of salts will be due to the presence of these cations and anions into the salt. Okay, if Cr3 plus is present, green color. Vanadium 3 plus is present, green color. Nickel 2 plus is present into the salt, color of salt will be green. Fe2 plus is present into the salt, color of salt will be green. If Cu2 plus is present into the salt, color of salt will be blue. If manganese 2 plus is present, cobalt 2 plus is present, color will be pink. If permanganate is present, pink color. If chromate anion is present into the salt, yellow color. If dichromate is present into the salt, salt will have orange color. Orange color. Right? Some example we can see. Some example of salts. Suppose I'm talking about nickel sulfate, NiSO4. So what will be the color of this salt? See, sulfate do not have any color. This salt is consist of sulfate 2 minus and Ni2 plus. If Ni2 plus is present, just before I told you, green chrome nahi fasa nahi means nickel. Color will be green. Okay. Copper sulfate, just before I told you all, copper 2 plus furnished represent which color? Blue color. Sulfate don't have any color, sulfate 2 minus. Copper 2 plus represents blue color. So this salt's color will be blue. Clear? If we talk about KMnO4, potassium permanganate, just before I told you all, representative elements do not show any color. So this potassium belongs to group number 1, means representative element. Do not show any color, means colorless. And permanganate represents which color? Pink color. So salts will represent pink color. I hope you people understood how to find out, how to understand what will be the color of salt. That's all for today. Thank you. In the next video, I will tell you all how sodium hydroxide and ammonium hydroxide react with salt to identify what components are present into the unknown salt. Okay, here we will understand known salt. Clear? Thank you.